everybody, and I'm going to be talking to you about my research, which is on how birdsong changes in different social contexts. And I got interested in this question because I have a desire that I consider to be a pretty fundamental human desire, and that is the desire to talk to animals. I'm a cat owner, and I spent a lot of time lying on the floor staring soulfully into my cat's eyes and trying to get her to understand what I'm saying. And I haven't had any luck with that yet, but there's a whole field of science called animal communication, which is about trying to decode the signals that animals are sending to each other and figuring out what they can tell us about the animals themselves. So the specific question that I'm interested in is how different social contexts can reveal variation between animals in these signals. And I like to explain my question by using a metaphor about running. So say you're trying to figure out which of two people is a faster runner. Well, the answer that you get all depends on the situation that you sample them in. So if you were to measure how fast they were going when they were jogging around campus on their casual morning run, you might find that they were going at about the same speed. But if you were to pit them against each other in a race, suddenly you might see that they were both going a whole lot faster, and that one of them was actually way faster than the other person. But this difference was only revealed because you looked at them in a competitive context. So I'm trying to look at the same thing in birdsong and see whether a competitive context can reveal variation between birds and songs that you might not see in an uncompetitive context. Now, I studied this question in dark-eyed juncos, which are this really cute little bird right here, and they're really common, so you've probably seen them like hopping around campus, even today. And I recorded them in the Sierra Nevada mountains of California in two different social contexts, one singing in response to a recording of another male bird, and that was my competitive context, and two singing spontaneously, and that was my uncompetitive context. Then I analyzed these recordings for different bird song traits to compare between the contexts. And what I expected to see was that the traits would be different between the two contexts, and that more variation in traits between birds would be revealed in the competitive context. Now, surprisingly, I found that not only was no variation revealed in the competitive context, but in fact, the traits weren't even different between the competitive and non-competitive social contexts. However, I think this suggests two really interesting possibilities. The first of which is that perhaps these traits aren't important for competition in my bird species in particular, and maybe there's some other trait that I didn't measure that would actually be different between the two different social contexts. And the second interesting possibility is that perhaps for juncos, singing in response to another male doesn't represent a strong competitive context. And if I looked at a different social context, for example, singing in front of a female that they're trying to mate with, maybe I would have seen differences in traits emerge. So moving forward, I'm going to continue analyzing recordings to look at different traits and keep trying to figure out what animals are saying to each other. Thank you.